Hello, people. To describe the concept of heaven, we need to go into science. The concept of straight line motion or straight line action can only exist if space is flat. There's a link for that, and there's another one there. That being the case, and it looks like it is, the science is 99% sure that it's a flat space universe, and from that it can be deduced or extrapolated that an endless state of motion or action needs to be of a linear type, hence the straight line action concept. Set the scroll down going. And let's pick up points as we go along. It's a continual state of becoming. The common way of looking at it is using the word evolution. Just let's see if there's a link for that. No, we'll put in a link for that. Just a moment. To continue. We're continually evolving in a Euclidean geometric reality. I think we need a link there as well, don't we? Just let's have a quick look. Yep. Okay. Just a moment, just pick a link in there. What we can become is best understood by appraising or studying or thinking about what pan-dimensionality is. Just a moment, we need another link there. It might sound very complicated, but when you get into it, it's not that difficult, really. There's only a few concepts that you can easily understand, and once you've done that, it's plain sailing. Right, well, infinity, another link, the concept of infinity includes the idea that there's an endlessness to reality. Reality. Let's put another link in there. There's going to be a lot of links in this, I'm afraid. Reality, when scrutinized, becomes a composition of three different things. In a quick sentence, it's mass, length and time. The link's just gone in for that. Within the concept of endlessness, we can construct a reality contains motion of the three things that are in the reality link. There may be more things to come, or there may be other things we haven't yet realized that make up what we experience from those three things. However, just to keep things as scientifically accurate as possible, we won't stray from the three-part makeup of reality. Now, making those three things available to our projections of what happens in the infinite is the infinite space. We need another link there. Space is endless. You'll find a description of it at that link. So it's just us and infinite space initially. And this is why the concept of love becomes important. Another link. When it's just beings and nothing, you will come to appreciate, if you don't already, that we need a qualitative state. And by qualitative, we mean something that everyone finds agreeable, if not desirable. Now, it so happens that the thing we call love is also a basis for perpetual motion. Another link. The initial motion that is sending us into infinity came from the Big Bang, which enables us, which when coupled with love, enables us to maintain perpetual motion. So we have an endless expanse of space occupied by beings like ourselves, although from evolution, the evolution link there, it's explained that we change our form. We don't retain our man-shaped shape, another link. We lose our man-shaped shape because that doesn't permit an extension into flat space reality, which contains a qualitative feeling. So we are forever going somewhere new. The straight line itself, as you will be able to appreciate for yourselves, doesn't come back on itself. It's an endlessly renewable position that cannot be retraced. So we're always going somewhere new, and we're always becoming something new, because the pan-dimensional potential contained in reality means that we have the scope to move from one dimension to another. We're in the third dimension at the moment. Another link. This link here will give you an insight into the time values that infinity contains. Time, another link. The link for time will give you an idea of how time can be broken into different categories. So time isn't an issue for us in heaven. It is an issue at the moment though, but we're going into a different area. So we've got at least three things happening in heaven in terms of motion. We're going somewhere new. And in the process of moving, we're becoming someone new. And we're changing form and always becoming something new. All right, let's move on. Back in the 1990s, when the writer began getting these insights into the future, he had a quick whiff, and I do mean quick, it was just a few seconds, possibly just two seconds. When the experience of the heavenly state became something he could latch onto mentally, and by far and away, the greatest sense in heaven is the sense of freedom. I really do wish I could convey it in a way it was felt at the time, and your yearning to experience the heavenly state would take on a whole new character. It would become a desperate, grasping to re-experience it continually. But it's there waiting for us. We've just got to keep in tune with reality long enough for the characteristics that we need to put us in good stead in heaven, become part of our being. A link was put in just a moment ago for permutations, and you'll appreciate pretty well endless, because we're using a mechanism that is completely alien to reality. There's a link there that may, or hopefully will give you insight into the character of love. And using the mechanism of love as emotion becomes an active, vibrant personality trait. Which is always experiencing, because of its mechanism, a new reality. I may need to explain that further on another entry. But here's the next thing. Is a number here. Now just let's see if we've got a link for that. I think we have. Yeah, we got a link. Just a moment. The link for powers of numbers will give you a few ideas on how to think about this time value here. The Earth lasts for 10,000 million years, with about 5,000 million years to go. The universe, or the galaxy, lasts for one race of the 11th power years. After that, the galaxy as we know it today will take on a different shape. It's the suns that are here will start to fizzle out, and the types of suns that we see in the sky, they will have run their cycle and become a lot emptier, and there'll be things called red dwarfs which go on for a few trillion years. But once the galaxies have run their course, which is a trillion is, I think that's a million. So that's 1 to the 12th power. And this number you're looking at here is 1 raised to the 83,000th power. The lines of zeros that are scrolling past you as we look at this, there's 100 zeros per line. Now 100 zeros is the length of time of the universe. That's how long the universe lasts for. The longest thing that exists in the universe is a black ball, or what is commonly referred to as a black hole. and that lasts for one race of the 100 power years. So each line is the length of a universe, so one before that number, means that that's the length of one universe, universal cycle. Now another figure there, that zero there, means that if we added a zero to that, that number would be 10 of those. So you've got to imagine a universe that goes on for one race to the 100th power years, and then by adding one more zero, it goes on for 10 times one race to the 100th power years. And if you added another zero, that would be 100 cycles of a universe, and three zeros would be 1,000, and you're starting to get some idea of just how big a time value the lover has carved out for us. I mean, well, you'll come to appreciate him, I'm sure, as you begin to understand what's happened and what is happening and what is going to happen. Your appreciation of him will be unbounded. Love is a mystery because of its unusual, unique characteristic. Reality couldn't have come up with something like that. I mean, it's completely new all the time. It's being refreshed and re-experienced in a slightly different way. And there's no way of predicting how it's going to manifest itself or show itself from moment to moment or from change to change. I'm not sure how quickly it changes, possibly every few seconds, every few hours. But with these time values involved, it could be much bigger. But there's just no way of telling at the moment. That's one aspect of the heavenly state I don't know about, but I do know that it changes in a more appealing way every time it does change. I suppose we could define the heavenly state as the as that state which cannot remain the same for any longer than ... whatever the minimum time value is for non-change to take place. But even then, our motion is continuous, so there's absolutely no way we can assign a repetitive scenario to the heavenly state. Now we don't have rockets, we don't have spaceships. In mathematical form, we can perform motions by thinking about them. It's quite a thought, isn't it? You think to yourself, well, I'm going to go from here to there now, and it just happens. Not in the quantum jump style, where we go from one, where something goes from one place to another without being anywhere in between. Our experience of the heavenly state is a fluid, constant experience of time. I'll swallow this down a bit quicker, we're going to run out of time. I can only use an hour on daily motion. I think I've got a bit longer on YouTube, but even then, we've it's a bit of a chore to take all this in, isn't it? But it's a big subject. I mean, we're talking about our endless future. If I could explain it in a couple of minutes, I don't know if we would be able to appreciate it in the way we would if we think about it in detail a little bit quicker. Ooh. Reciprocation means giving back in equal measure that which was given. So when you're giving back something which is greater than the amount you had before you was given it, the amount you pass on is greater than the amount you give were given, and that in turn is added to the other beings' feelings. So there's an accumulative increasing of the length of time motion can be experience. When you're in infinity, you realize just how hopeless it is to think in terms of exhausting infinity. It just can't be done. And as the understanding, the feeling for the infinite permeates or gets into your mind, you realize that you're in a hopeless state of inexhaustibility. It just can't be exhausted. The only thing that can be exhausted is if your feelings were to take on a repetitive aspect. But even so, if you find something enjoyable, then you don't mind repeating it. Well, I don't. I mean, I can think of a few things that I enjoy doing over and over. But it isn't like that. There aren't just a handful of things that we do over and over. The nature of reality is such that it's got endless characteristics. You'll be overwhelmed by the sense of the endlessness of space. It cannot be grasped. We are and always will be finite beings. Albeit we can increase our appreciation of our relative or comparative or complementaritative relationship with space. Just a moment, I think we need a link there. There's a link in now for complementarity. That's a concept, a concept which was arrived at when quantum theory was being... Well, we need another link for quantum theory, don't we? Just a moment. There's a link in for quantum theory now if you want to familiarise yourself with what it's about. It's all quite simple, really. It's just the mathematical symbolic formalism associated with classical education makes it difficult for the average person to break into. Look at the time. Look at the time you're going to experience. You're all going to Heaven's Highway. That's my pet name for it. There's no way we're going to appreciate the time scales involved here. Bearing in mind that it's a finite, this number we're looking at is a finite value. It reduces to zero when you divide it by infinity. Every numerical value does that. So, as impossibly long as it is from our point of view, within the context of eternity, it's just a moment. In 1 raised to the 83,000th power years, or a little bit longer next time, I don't know how much it increases by, we'll be back here doing the same things. So time isn't the concept that was generally held, was that once you entered heaven, it was there forever. Subjectively, it will seem forever, but objectively, we know it's a finite value. A lot of the concepts of heaven were just completely off the mark. Still are. I mean, you try and persuade somebody who's with a got a slightly zealous or zealot type view of religion, there's no way you're going to break through with the idea that heaven comes to an end. So it's all down to appreciating what science knows and incorporating what science does know into a manageable perspective. If you like being surprised, get ready to be surprised continually. Pleasantly surprised, of course. There aren't any shock surprises or untoward surprises. Every new surprise will be an appealing one. Time won't have any meaning to us while we're traversing the straight line. Pleasure doesn't really figure in our heavenly state experience in the way it does now. It will be completely surpassed by the feelings we get from motion, experiencing the other person. Pleasure might just be a purely procreational thing. Of course, I don't know that, but the pleasure of being as opposed to the pleasure of doing. I think there's a difference there. We transfer our feelings of pleasure into pleasure of being. So we're destined to go through this earthly evolution. Another link. We're destined to go through what we're going through now. Into eternity. For eternity. It defines eternity, probably. Each new undulation. There's a link there. We're slightly more in tune with ourselves and other people. Things are a little bit better, less violence, less death, more happiness, more life. It's just a matter of persuading people through common sense and science. You know that feeling you get when you start a new relationship? How exciting it be, how the newness of it, anticipating what's coming. That's another renewable feeling we experience in heaven. As the beings evolve bit by bit, so the relationship, if we have a relationship with one person and the relationship finishes, and then sometime later that person experiences life and the experiences become part of their personality, and you meet the person again and the relationship is different to the one that you initially experienced. That will give you another reason to want to keep on changing. I'm looking forward to doing some of the motions that we experience as heavenly beings. We don't sleep in heaven, we don't eat, We just play and play and play. Right. Even as we speak, there's one or two new thoughts that need to be introduced into this entry. So we have to do this entry all over again in the not too distant future. But for now, that's it. I hope you've got somebody you can talk these ideas through with, because you'll find it more rewarding to speak to them, to speak about them with somebody who is of an equal outlook or an equal disposition to life as yourself. See you later, guys.